everyone, and a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. So guys, in our previous session, we have covered that how with the help of Beautiful Soup, we can use the find all function to extract all the data from our website if we have the tag and the attribute. In our today's session, we will be understanding that if you want to extract the data with the help of regular expressions, then how we can do that. So let's have a look on how it can be done. So guys, for this, again, we will be writing import requests. The same library we will be using, that from BS4 import beautiful soup. Also, we will be importing RE, that is our regular expressions. So this library RE, it stands for regular expressions. It helps us find a pattern in a string and then it extracts the data related to that pattern. So for this, I'll be again writing URL is equals to, I'll pass the URL of our test website. And here we will be writing R is equals to requests dot get, and in this I'll be passing URL. Here I'll be writing soup is equals to beautiful soup. Here I'll be writing R dot text, comma. Our file will be handled in XML. And lastly, if you want to, okay, in our previous session, we have learned that how we can get the data from our tags. Suppose if you want to pass multiple tags also, we can pass that as well. For example, we can write for any data. Data is equals to soup dot find underscore all. And here you can pass multiple tags as well. So suppose if I go back here, click on inspect. And if we have multiple data, so let's just go over here. And here we have data in H4 tag, in P tag. Okay, we have it in A tag as well. So we can pass all three of them here by writing H4 inside the quotations, comma, A tag, comma, P tag. And we can print the data like this as well. So as soon as I run it, so everything that is there in H4 tag, A tag and P tag will appear over here. So this is how this works. And now if I talk about the regular expressions. So if I write anything, for example, here, if I write find all where our string value is equal to, let's say, if I go back to our website, here we have Lenovo Idea tab, here we have Idea tab, Acer Iconia, if I write Galaxy tab 3. So I want to obtain this Galaxy tab 3. So I'll be writing Galaxy tab 3. And I want to see how many of the Galaxy tab 3s are over here. So you will see that there are two Galaxy tab 3. And if I go back to the website also, here we have one Galaxy tab 3. And if we scroll down, there is another Galaxy tab 3. Both are different because both has like different descriptions here. And only two of them are there. Another one is there, that is Galaxy tab. So if I search for Galaxy tab only, instead of three, if I only search for Galaxy tab, in that case, I will only get one Galaxy tab over here. So you can see, even if I write Galaxy tab, I will not get Galaxy tab 3 or Galaxy tab 4. Why? Because we have written down the string here. Suppose if we would have passed a regular expression. For regular expression, I'll be writing. So let me just put this data inside the comment. And here, if I write data is equals to soup dot find all, and here I'll be writing string is equals to re dot compile, and what we will be compiling over here is Galaxy. And as soon as I run it, you will see we will get all the tabs, every detail that on the page, wherever there is a Galaxy written over there, we'll get everything related to that Galaxy tab 3, Galaxy tab 3, Galaxy tab 4, Galaxy tab, Galaxy Note, Galaxy Note, Galaxy Note 10.1. So this is how we can get the data with the help of regular expressions. Now you can give anything over here. For example, we have Idea tab, we have Lenovo tab, everything is there, right? So I'll be writing Idea here, and as soon as I run it, here we have Lenovo Idea tab A3500L, A Idea tab A850, Idea tab A3500H, and Idea tab S5000. This is how, with the help of regular expressions, you can get the data. So I hope this thing is clear to you, that how we have used the regular expressions here. And not just on this website, if I talk about any other website, for example, if I go to website for courses.wscubetech, and here, if I look for any term, for example, I want to see how many times WsCube Tech is coming over here. So for that, I'll just copy this And if I go back here, I'll paste this thing here inside the double quotes. I'll paste it and I'll also change the link. So for the link, I'll copy the link from the top and come back to my program. If I scroll it down and change the URL to this one and paste it. And if I run it, so we will be getting welcome to WsCube Tech, and then we have different strings over here, and I guess this is a huge data. So what I'll do, I'll just pass the length here, that len of this data. So I want to actually extract all the strings which says WsCube Tech. So it says 4 times, and in this method, in this manner it is written 4 times. Maybe in different manner it would have been written in a different way. For example, if I remove the space from between, in that case it would give me 0 times, that 0 times it is coming. And if I talk about only WsCube and then if I run it, it would give me 4 again. So yeah, this is how it works basically. That you can search for anything from your website by using string is equals to re.compile. And if you are looking for the exact word, in that case, you do not need to use the regular expressions. In that case, you can simply write string is equals to in whatever your exact word is. So I hope guys that you have no doubts in the questions in how we have used the find all function along with the regular expressions. In our next session, we are going to talk about how we can use regular expressions along with the pandas. So stay connected guys, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.